are TV cameras.
Oh.
That's why. There we go. Hey, everyone.
We're here with a commentary attempt. I'm gonna try to fix my HUD. Okay, they're at 200. Let's go to 0. Let's go to 0 or 20. Confirm video. Let's go to, that. So we get good visuals. Okay, so we're on the side, finally. Made it. Cycle the head there. Okay. We'll keep it full. Okay, cool. I don't think anyone knows I'm doing this. So I just want to see how this goes. It's probably gonna be terrible. We got GTR in the distance. We got 2 minutes here to the green flag. This is the reverse grid race for EU. I have no idea who won. I think it was Pete in the Lexus, that 333 car. But yeah, I don't actually know. We'll go to Helicam just to mess around, or actually, we'll do this and we'll disconnect it from the car. Just go park at a turn. We'll pretend we're a photographer. Where's the pit exit? Okay. We're just gonna park over here for a bit. This pit exit. So we can just watch some people come out of the pits here. Here he is. Look at that. Watch Aaron Jackson, my teammate in endurance. One of my teammates in endurance. Drive along. Getting a little bit of oversteer on exit there. Getting a lot of oversteer here. He's having a good time. Having way too much fun. Alright, let's go ahead and re-enable this. It's out of here. I'm gonna stay on Aaron for a bit. Alright, so practice is coming to an end here. This is a reverse grid race. The grid order has already been decided. So they're actually gonna be going straight into the race here in a bit. The text for the join DRL is kind of covering the conditions all. I'll hide it, I guess. Let's plug in my phone. Alrighty, I'll read off the starting grid once we get there, because I really, again, I don't actually know. I'm also going to bind a key that isn't on my wheel to cycle the HUD. There isn't already one. I'll cycle HUD and empty up. The fuck? Shift insert already does it. Okay. Shift insert. Sick. Alright. Here's the overall standings. I think only one person said a lot, because there's just practice before the reverse grid race. Got two people coming across the line right now. And that's it. Alright, so, on the front of the grid here, let's get all the way up. We've got Lorenz and the Ferrari. Let's go. Let's not die. Oh, I have to click drive. There we go. Okay. Well, starting this off, we got Lorenz and Bissell in the front row, Ferrari and Aston respectively, both the AM-class. We've got AM-class drivers for a while here, because this is full reverse grid, not just like top whatever. Next, we've got G. Slater in the Bentley, and next to him, A. Walker. Behind them, we've got T. Unwin in a very nice, I like that blue. I actually just saw a Lamborghini like with this color in real life, like probably half an hour ago. Next to them, we've got Steve Poe crossing the ocean to drive a very bright green and black and silver Mercedes. Row behind them, we've got Lauren De Jong. I'm totally butchering all of these pronunciations. Purple and gold, I dig it. And next to them, on the fourth row, we've got C. Betts in the 94 Aston. Ninth and tenth are Dan Schneider, another person from the NA side, and Hughes. I guess they're teammates with Unwin. Those are very similar color schemes. The first pro driver, we've got Scholes in the GTR, and Pim Van Mill in this very wonderful looking blue Audi. I think that's just a default livery in the game. Behind them, we've got Jay Harninmi in the 48 AMG and Luka Gluglovski in this McLaren. We've got A. Ertan in the based NSX. Coolest car in the game. Absolutely love it. Totally not biased at all. And then in 16th, we've got Jesper Roland, another AM driver. 17th, we've got Pontus Carlbom in this black and gold Aston. 18th, we got Kai Gulliver in the number 19 green and black Aston, another AM driver, another AM driver. 19th, we've got A. Jewsbury in the 73 Aston. 20th, we've got, I like this color a lot, A. Ja in the 25 McLaren. 21st, we got Rob Franken in the 999 Aston. 22nd, Aaron Jackson, the man, the myth, the legend. 23rd, Timu Ladama in another default livery, and I'm gonna skip down the timing table here. Alright, 24th, Chris Pika, another DRL legend right here, the 911 Porsche, very fitting. In 25th, we've got Nigel Terran, these are all like the winners of the last race, basically. This is top five right here. Nigel Terran in the black and yellow Ferrari. 26th, we got Joachim Schellgren, another Aston. We've got a lot of Astons. A lot of them. Eric Engman in the Ferrari, the 909. Another endurance friend. Jean-Sebastien Casangana on the back row here in the McLaren. And then last race's winner. And starting from the very back, we've got Pete in the Lexus, which I'm a little surprised he's driving, considering that's what we did our endurance championship in, but you know what? If he can put up with that car, good for him. Hell yeah. Alrighty. We've got 30 seconds here, so everyone's gonna start clicking drive pretty soon, I imagine. I'll go to the helicam of the front runners. Eventually. There we go. That's not helicam. That's helicam. Alright, so we're gonna watch these guys take off. We got AM drivers all up in the top 10. I predict Scholes. Everyone behind them, really, all the pro drivers are going to really try to fight through the field. We'll see how far up everyone can get, but it may be a while. Neither of these two front-running cars have particularly good acceleration, but the ones behind them do, the Bentley and the Beamer. So I would not be surprised to see particularly Bissell jumped by Slater or Walker off the line. The Aston and the Ferrari are not exactly known for their acceleration. I also expect Scholes to get someone off the line because he's behind a McLaren and a Lambo, and the Nissan hauls ass off the line. So we're waiting, you know, got the full formation lap going. They gotta work their way around the whole track once. Warm up their tires, you can see them all weaving around a little bit up here. A lot of them, if they're smart, they'll be riding their brakes. Let's go to the HUD to see what he's doing. Yeah, he's riding his brakes. That's actually, so obviously we can't see their tire temperature from up here, but riding the brakes is a slightly more effective way in this game than just weaving. if you keep your brake pads warm, they'll heat up the tires kind of from the inside as opposed to just heating the surface, which is super helpful for getting overall temperature in. Makes the first lap a little less sketchy as well if your brakes are warmed up. Pull up a track map on the other side of it, like with turn numbers on my other screen. Images. That is good enough. Okay, cool. Alright, cool. Damn it. That's annoying. Okay. I'm like guessing with that resolution here. Alright, that works. Because my stream resolution, my game resolution right now is 1920 by 1080, but I have an ultra wide, so like every time I jump back and forth, it stretches stuff on the other screen. So yeah. Just gonna double check everything's working in Streamlabs again. Alright, cool. Seems to be. Oh, looks like Kessingen is dropping out of the race. His force feedback is not working. That's fucking tragic. Hit it so well in the first race, but now he's gone. Alright, looks like they're all stacking up here. Because at some point the formation lap tells you to stack up next to the other drivers instead of just driving along your own way. So they're stacking up here, and they come around to the final corner. And then they will start the race as soon as they get to that line, I think. So we'll go to Helicam to watch the start here. And we'll go back to the broadcasting hut. Somebody's gonna get a drive-through. That Aston is way out of position.
Green light, give it all you can.
Or not. Alrighty, off we go. Lorenz gets a great start. Keeps their first place ahead of Bissell. Behind them. Oh, wow, what a move from the Mercedes. Alright, we're in there. I'm gonna zoom out. Alright, looks like we got some incidents back here. Harami and Schulz died. Oh, we got a lot more too. Franken got punted. Taren's in the wall. Engman's coming back on the track. I didn't really see what happened. Wow! What the fuck is going on? What is... This is a car park out here. Jesus. Okay. Well. Alright. Wow. That's unfortunate. That's terrible coverage at the start. That's my bad. I should have been in a side camera from the beginning. Let's get back to Lorenz is way out in front. Already got a second gap to the car behind. Let's skip to some battles here. We got Lucas. Pim's already worked his way up to third. That's awesome. Pro drivers cutting through the field like crazy, although I'm sure it helped that some of them were, that a lot of people were punted out of the way. Oh, that's a restart. Okay. That was really bad. Alright, well, I get a shot to I get to restart my broadcast. I guess. That was Golden, I think, restarted that. Or Matthias. Someone restarted that. Wasn't me. That's pretty bad. That's pretty bad. Alright. You know what to do better this time. And that is be in F7 camera statically through 1 and 2 before. Alright, well, Lorenz had a really good start. It's a shame that they couldn't hold on to it. So maybe, so Kessingen might have a chance to join back here and fix their force feedback. See how that goes. I'm just gonna do like a leisurely walk down the middle here. What in the hell? Disabled. The jumps you see are people making setup adjustments. to explain a little bit more about the format. This is a 30-minute reverse grid race. The first race was just the regular 30 minutes with a qualifying session beforehand. The reverse grid is based off of the results from the previous race. So these are the fast guys in the back. There's the slightly slower guys in the front. It's 30 minutes. It's only 30 minutes. So while that might seem like a long time, it's a sprint race. And there's no mandatory pit stop or anything. It's going to be real interesting. I think this is the first sprint race for these guys. Or like the first reverse grid. But yeah, we'll get to see how people... This is going to be more focused on racecraft and less focused on tire strategy and whatnot. So cars like the Porsche, for example, will do very well here. Or should do very well in these sprints. Whereas some cars that are better endurance might suffer a little bit.
20 seconds.
Depends on a lot of things, really. You can hear the pit box. Hey, Pete. You can hear the race engineer counting down in the background. That's just part of the game. Off goes Lorenz. I love that color scheme. Green, purple, and pink. It's the trifecta. Pete, you should get back to racing. Now Kaisen's gonna say he can't find the server. Let's go through the team names. So we got just an independent Lorenz, we got Bissell Motorsport, Enigma Racing, Alex Walker Racing, Unwin Motorsport, Team Bad Luck, I dig it, Slightly Offensive Racing, Golden Breakin' Racing, Slightly Offensive Racing, okay, so these two are teammates. I guess. Whatever. No team. Kaiju Delta Racing number 2. Phoenix Racing. No team. Green Shell Racing. I like it. No team. It's below 9,000. Kaiju. Slow. Slow. Slick Racing. Kaiju Racing. We've got some Kaiju reps out here. That's an endurance team that we raced against in RCI. Thundercross Racing. That's a classic. Thundercross Split Attack. Orange 1 Triple F Racing. That's, again, an in-game livery. Porsche Motorsport. The Chris Classic. Nigel Terran with no team. Another Kaiju. Eric with no team. And Pete with the understeer in Sector 2, which... I really hope you're not understeering in this particular Sector 2, but I mean, it's a good name. It's a good name. Yeah. So we'll see where they start stacking up. Not totally sure where it'll be. Probably around that hairpin. Just watch Lorenz for a bit. Getting on and off the brakes. Like I mentioned earlier, the top 10 drivers on the starting grid in this race are our AM drivers, and then we start getting kind of a mix. The pro drivers want to make their way through these guys as quickly as possible. Before the restart, we saw Pim in the 619 Audi doing very well at that. Alright, they're stacking up now. Yeah, stack up the hairpin. So yeah, about one corner to go, and then a very slow quality line. They'll be off! That's a bit out of position.
Green light. Give me
that's it, that's the start. Alright, some people off the track, but nothing crazy yet. Much cleaner than last race. Good job, guys. Nope, just kidding. Someone's around. It looks like Steve Poe and the AMG, and everyone's kind of going around them. Looks like Schneider might have gotten taken out too in that mess, the white McLaren. Alrighty. So far, so good. People running a little wide up here, but it's nothing crazy. It's Misano, you're allowed to do that. The track limits are very generous here. Alrighty. Looks like, for the most part, the field got around at least the first sector pretty unscathed. Lorenz extending his lead up in front of Bissell and Walker. Pim only up to ninth now. We got a couple yellow flags. People spin around at this hairpin. This is a very popular space for people to dive bomb. Looks like the NSX and Adama and the Lambo got taken out. Lorenz running the fuck away. Let's go. Up to 1.5 seconds in less than a lap on his opponents. Alright, this is the longest straight on this track. Both of these corners are flat out. Then you have a pretty sketchy braking zone into this turn here. Into turn 13. Ooh, bit messy there. Walker pushing their way through. People going off here, Glogowski and Roland. That's going to be a bit of a messy rejoin. We'll see. That's not a great place to go off. Roland really dropping places. Glogowski disconnects. Understandable. Oh no, he got disqualified. He cut the corner too much. I've seen that happen before. Alrighty. We'll go back to the TV camera. Lorenz, 3 seconds ahead already. So let's go see some battles. This looks like a battle. The two Lamborghinis right next to each other. Along with Betts in the Aston. He's going a bit wide there. Oh, this is a good four-way battle for third place at the moment. I don't have a lot of faith they'll stay third place, but I mean, anything's possible. Behind them we've got Schultz kind of by himself, and then we got a four-way battle with Slater, Aaron. Where did Slater go? Oh, nope, they touched. Aaron keeps it straight. They both keep it relatively straight, though. That's awesome. Carrying on, Aaron gets the better of that mix. I don't know what place he's in. I guess he's in 10th. I don't know where Slater is. Alright, they're coming across the timing line now. Okay, Aaron's in 10th. Slater got dropped somewhere. Okay, I didn't see where he went. The 607 is in the pits. I don't know who that is. Alright, they're coming around. Let's see what other battles we got here. Oh, that's a five-way. This is going to get spicy. Chris taking it easy, kind of claiming the middle of the line there. Porsche acceleration going around the Bentley, but he has to give it up because the Bentley is the inside. Oh, just kidding. And Chris takes the spot. All right, let's go. This is looking very feisty. A lot of pro drivers here, and Slater just getting kind of caught up in the mix is the only am in this little fight. Just kidding. Timing doesn't really like updating. I guess he's damaged. He's backing out of these moves really early. Pete going around there in the Lexus. Let's see what these guys can do. It's not where you want to be around that turn. You don't really want the outside, because then you get kind of hung out to dry and you got to adjust your line. Let's see if Franken will do anything. We got a yellow flag. The 375 car spun out somewhere, but looks like they're moving again. Who's going the wrong way? Someone just going the wrong way across the camera. I guess that was the GTR of someone. I think that was the GTR of Scholes. Yeah, Scholes tumbling down the timetables now. He's getting pretty far back. Yeah, there he is, all the way over there. Alright. Let's see what else we got going on in the field here. We got the Lambo of Hughes and the Ferrari of Engman. I guess Engman just got past him. I think Engman's going to try chasing Pico down. We've got a yellow flag up here. Looks like a couple spinners. A BMW and an Aston. Let's watch this Pico and Engman battle. This looks like it's going to be good. These are two very good drivers in very different cars. The Porsche is known for its acceleration and just ridiculously good handling through low-speed corners, just a lot of mechanical grip. And the Ferrari has really good aero, pretty alright top speed, where the Porsche has none. So I think in the defensive battle, I think Chris will have it, but Eric's a good driver. If he wants to find a way around, I'm sure he will. Porsche also has better brakes than the Ferrari, so it's going to be interesting. Eric is going to have to be careful while following. Very close there. This is a good scrap right here. I think this goes up to like fifth place, yeah. A lot of people going off. Oh no, Eric spun! I think he got hit back there. Well, Chris is still going. He's got Pontus and two AM drivers ahead of him. So we'll see what he can do with that. These AMs are not going to want to give up positions. Ooh, bit of contact there. But no harm, no foul. Rubbing is racing. I think Betts retired to the pits in the 94 car. We got a lot of people going back to the pits now. This is unfortunate. But I mean, this is what happens with the reverse grids. It gets kind of spicy sometimes. And you see Lambo pulling a gap on Piquet, even with the slipstream. Chris is struggling to keep up because the Porsche's top speed just isn't there. It's got a massive wing and a massive front splitter, but that wing creates a lot of drag. But it looks like he might... Wow! Got him down the inside. I don't know how much of that was Unwin letting him by, but it was a good move regardless. Let's see what else. What other battles do we have here? The top group looks pretty sorted. Tarin and Sjogren battling for the final podium position at the moment. Pim Van Mill ahead of them. And Lorenz just stretching his advantage even further. Am driver absolutely taken off up there. It's very easy to get a corner cut warning at that turn, at turn 6 there, going either too far in or too far out. You can really cut corners on this track, but there are still limits. Hit the Audi running away a little bit there. Very loud engine. Alrighty, I thought Taren might try to set up something on exit here. We'll see. He's definitely got the slipstream down the equivalence of a back straight here at Misano. I wonder if he'll try anything into 13. It's a pretty risky spot to go for it, but I mean, they both got enough downforce to respect each other there. Alright, he didn't go for anything. He's a bit wide, a bit out of shape going into 14. Jogging with very good blocking, just holding his line, taking it easy. Turn a bit messy on the exit there. Jogging will hold this for another lap. Everyone else is pretty spread out right now, you know, a second or so. Pontus and Ronnie. I'm just gonna fuck up that name every time I try, so. Yeah. There's another good battle, this for fifth place. The only cars that are really close are Franken, Ertan, and Bissell. I guess Pete and Unwin. Tarn looks like he fell off a little more. We'll go back to Franken and Ertan. These two are in the same class. This is a battle for the last of the top 10 here. We got the NSX versus the Aston. I'm going to be biased and root for the NSX because it's the coolest car. We've also got Eric Engman down in 17th fighting his way up to the field, as well as Laurent Dujon, only half a second behind their next opponent. We got people coming out of the pits at least now, so not everyone's just totally retired. The NSX has a top speed advantage in a lot of scenarios. I don't think it's particularly good at the EU tracks, but it's good at a lot of the others. The Aston's good everywhere. So we'll see what he can do. I wonder what engine mode is he running. He is running mode 1. Okay. I prefer mode 2 in that car. The throttle response is a little different between them. Looks like Pontus has fallen off the back of Harney and me a little bit. Shogun's getting real close. Let's go look at that. I'm just kidding. Okay. Pete and Chris. Are we going to see something here? Nope. Pete backs out of it just a little bit. Lexus definitely has a top speed advantage here. I mean, everything does over the Porsche, but the Porsche will outrun it from a dig. Coming down to the hairpin here before the back straight. We'll see if Pete can get a good slipstream on him. This is going to be a good four-way battle, I think. See Ertan and Frank in the background there. Looks like Carbon's pulling away a little bit from these two. Just a little bit. Actually, I think Pika and Rosalina got a much better exit out of that final corner. All these drivers very good. These 2 through 7, 2 through 8, and then Lorenz as well has just escaped all the chaos at the start. Kept his head down. Started in the lead, still in the lead. Pim Van Mills catching him, but catching him slower than I would have thought. He was up from 8 seconds behind to about 5.5. And Pim is being chased down by Tyron Jalgren as well. There's a bit of a gap. As Pete goes for it down the inside here. Very clean, very nice. Chris didn't really have anywhere to go. Beautiful move from Pete. I'll see if he can keep it. Chris missing his breaking point, going a little wide, but setting up for a... Doesn't say setting up for a late apex, but I think he missed it there too. Unfortunate. And Pete up into 7th, swapping places with Chris Pika. Who else is real close down the field? These two were close, I guess not anymore. Oh, maybe that's what happened. I think they went off. This is going to develop, I think. Eric and Scholes. Look like Scholes might have some damage here. Yeah, he's got some damage. Okay. That's unfortunate. That Nissan doesn't... I mean, the Nissan can take damage because it didn't really have much aero in the first place. We'll see how this goes. These are both also very good drivers. Although I think Eric's going to take him here pretty soon. Just... due to damage and other factors. He's not pitting, he's staying out for it. His tires are probably messed up from going through the grass a few times. Nissan will have the braking and acceleration advantage. I'm not really sure who has top speed advantage, but they're not really hitting much of a top speed here at Misano. That back straight has two big turns in it, and it's not that long. So we'll see. Kind of hugging the inside there, taking side turn lines to the corners. He's not really defending that hard. Eric's not quite close enough to give him a run. But if he goes wide like that, Eric can dive down the inside. And they'll go somewhat side by side through here, and then it'll be a bit of a drag race down to this next turn. So we'll see what we got here in a second. Eric's on the outside, Scholes on the inside. Braking late. Eric has more downforce. He can go around him, but Scholes holds onto the inside, defends. Eric goes pretty wide. But Eric will have the inside of the next turn. But Scholes is still fighting it out. Eric finally takes the inside on the hairpin onto the back straight. But I don't know. They're both damaged. I don't know if Scholes is done yet. He's got the slipstream. He's got a much better accelerating car. We'll see if he fights it back to the next couple corners here after 12 and 13. He thought about it, he moved to the inside, but he didn't do it. Alright, coming into 14 here. Yeah, I think Eric's got it at this point. That was a great battle between the two of them. Alright, let's see what else we got. We got Chris still chilling up here with Pontus and Pete. This battle's still going.
We are at the halfway mark, keep pushing.
Alright, we're halfway through. We've also got these three guys. Or we did. I don't know what happened. They were pretty close to each other. Where's Pim? What happened to Pim? 619. I don't see him on the track. I don't see him on the track map. That's unfortunate. Okay. Well, Tyrone's chilling in second, I guess. Nope, he's in four. What the fuck is going on? What happened to these guys? What happened to Pim? Okay, well, we've got Pete and Harnimi fighting. This is still the four-way battle. This is fantastic. We've also... Okay, Pim, Franken. So that's what's happening. Pim must have gone off track, gotten hit or something, because now he's back here with Franken and Ertan. As they go around the AM driver of Unwin, who very nicely lets them all by. Sitting second in class is fantastic, and quite a gap to third. Frank and a Pim fighting it out. These guys still fighting out. This is gonna happen the whole race, I think. We'll look at Pete for now. Yeah, this is a great four-way battle for fourth place here. Not quite a podium fight, unfortunately. Maybe if one of them gets loose, they can go after Tyrone, but right now the podium's looking pretty set with Lorenz up front, Jelgren in second, and Tyrone in third. He's made up quite a few spots. Remember, he started last. So this is great. He's up to fifth in, what, 15, I guess, 17, 18 minutes into a half-hour race. He's gone from dead last to fifth place, which is awesome. And I wouldn't be surprised if he makes his way up to fourth. There's a bit of a gap ahead to third, but I can see Pete taking fourth here. Someone is off. It's Tyrone. He's warped back to the pits. Suddenly, this is a podium fight. I don't know what happened to Tyrone. I saw him parked off to the side there, and now he's got a little pit lane indicator. So this is now a four-way fight for third place. Car 11, Tion win. Oh, that's brutal. That's second in class. He's got a drive through. That's taking him out of podium contention in class for sure. That sucks. But that's Misano for you. There's a lot of places where you have to cut corners, where it's allowed, but it's so easy to push it just a little bit too far and get a drive-through for it. That blows. That might have been a corner cut for Pete right there on the inside. All right, he's got a bit of a slipstream here. I don't think he's going to be close enough, but Lexus doesn't have that crazy brakes. But he thinks about it, looks up the inside. Maybe putting it into Harnamy's head that, yo, I'm here. Gets a much better exit down the inside. Harnamy runs a bit wide there. But Pete's on the outside here. But he's fighting it. He's going to see if he can go around the outside, squeeze Harnamy down to the inside. All right, let's see who can accelerate better out of this turn. So far, it looks like that AMG power's got it. But Pete is very close behind. I've said it before, I'll say it again. I wouldn't be surprised to see him move into 13. Or just go for it here. He's looking up the inside. He's got it! He does it into 12! Who are you? I've never seen anyone pass into 12 before. That's crazy. Let's go, Pete. Up into third. Let's see if he can run away with it now. Jogan just chilling a second. Hand me down to fourth, out of the podium places. I know he's going to want to fight that back, but I don't know if he'll be able to. Pete is just running away with these. He's already pulled half second plus gap. That was a crazy move. I've seen people go for it into 13. I haven't seen anyone stick it up the inside of 12 and like it work out. That's wild. Alright, Tion Wynn coming into the pits. He's already been passed by Jesper Roland. We'll see. This isn't the longest pit lane in the world, but he'll probably lose a couple spots. He's passed by Eric. Then he's passed by 35 and Scholes. He might... Okay, he'll come out of the pits in 4th in class. So he might still be able to fight it back. If he puts his foot down. Pontus and Chris are hungry. I think they're going to want to try to take 4th here. Again, I don't know if they'll be able to, but... I'm going to bet they'll want to. Unwin coming out just ahead of Steve Poe out of the pits there. You can see it on the mini map. hop back a couple spots here. Pim down in 7th, Franken in 8th with Ertan right behind him in that NSX. Again, the coolest car on the grid. As they scream down to through 12 and through 13. I think a lot of the other positions in this race are kind of set at this point. But these ones still up for grabs. I think 8th still up for grabs. I think 4th and 5th are still up for grabs. Anything's possible. And who knows, someone could spin. Lorenz could spin, Kjellgren could spin, and throw this race wide open. Chris falling off the back of Pontus a little bit. Up in front. Just a little bit, though. Coming out of 3 into 4. If Pontus gets what he wants, what I imagine he wants, he's got much better cornering through here. He might be able to make a run of it into, what is that, 8? Because this kink right here is like technically a turn. Yeah, okay. Not yet. I think that Mercedes is going to have an acceleration advantage and therefore speed advantage down the back straight. So I don't think much is going to happen there. Frank and Ertan, these two have been going at it the whole race, it feels like. Ertan just right behind, unable to quite make anything work. The Aston's got better brakes. I think it's overall a better car for the most part, minus maybe top speed. And that's not really a factor at this track. So it's been real hard for Ertan to make a move past Franken. What else we got? We can look at Steve Poe down the field in 15th, fighting for 4th place with Unwin after his drive-through. I think he's slowly been gaining on him. I don't think it'll be enough. But anything's possible. Steve is very... Having raced against Steve Poe in the past, he's very good. He's very aggressive. He's not necessarily the fastest and the most consistent driver, but he's one of the toughest fighters out there. If he wants to get past you, he will. And if he doesn't want you to get past him, you won't. He's very good at that. So we'll keep an eye on this delta and circle back if it gets any closer. Ertan sticking the nose down the inside just a little bit. Saying, hello Franken, what's up? I'm still here. You can't get rid of me that easily. But he can't get anything done out of these corners. The Aston's got the downforce. He's got the cornering speed to just stay ahead. A bit of a messy line there. Cut that corner so tight. We'll also keep an eye on Lauren DeJong's delta to Walker. They're getting pretty close too, about a second apart. Lorenz still in the lead of this race as the AM driver. With quite a gap to Kjellgren, I think he's got it. I think he's got the win if he can just keep it on the track for 6 more minutes. Alright, Ertan, I think got a better exit here. He's going to have a slipstream going down the back straight again. Breaking into 13. Oh! Is he going to save it? That counts. That's a save. That counts as a save. Good shit. Let's go. I think that's 8th place out of the question for him, but kept it together, kept it out of the wall. He's still going. He can still bring it home in 9th. You hate to see it, but at the same time, that could have gone a lot worse. Especially that particular corner coming through 13 into 14. You can get disqualified really easily there, as we saw earlier. Let's go back to Lauren DeJong. They look pretty close now. Just kidding. DeJong got past Walker. I don't know what happened to Walker. Okay. That's unfortunate. Okay. I guess we'll go back and watch this battle for the rest of the race, because this is as close as it gets. These guys are still going at it. Nobody quite able to gain an advantage. Pete extending his lead to 2.7 seconds out in front. Ooh, Jacques is catching Lorenz. I don't know if it'll be enough, but he is catching. I know Lorenz is really going to want this. This will be awesome if he can hold it, because that'll be, you know, flag-to-flag win as an AM driver, no less, in a sprint race. The reverse grid. Last to first. quickly rehash the strengths. The Mercedes here, this Mercedes is an all-rounder car. It's got pretty good acceleration due to its massive naturally aspirated V8, I think. That's what the engine is. I don't remember if the Evo has a twin turbo. The Aston is a very high corner speed car, very good all around, just a bit lacking in acceleration. And then the Porsche is a aggressive driver's dream. Best acceleration in the game, probably the best braking in the game. I think the only car that comes close is the Nissan. Bit of lacking top speed, but you can just toss it into corners all day. And since we're in a sprint race, you don't really have to care about tire degradation or anything. You can just drive the nuts off it. So we'll see what these guys get up to in the last few laps here. Fenwick gets a little bit out of shape. Chris taking a wide line through there. I think that was just a simple mistake. These guys have been within a second of each other for so long now. I know they're... I'm sure Hernemi is going to want to finish like this. But I'm sure that Carlbaum and Pika would like to move up a spot or two. I'm sure they'll be happy with these, but they're racing drivers. They want to go for all of it. They want to go for as much as they can. Switchback here. It's going to be a drag race down to turn 8. Carlbaum will have the inside. This is going to get good. Hey, right, Carlbaum takes the inside, pushes Hirony a little bit wide, and Carlbaum's got it. Chris might have it too. He's got the acceleration, but the AMG has the inside for this turn. Chris on the outside. Let's see if he can make a massive late apex and just fly down the main straight here. Hernemi is also kind of eyeing Carlbaum back. I think he's got the slipstream, so we'll see if they try anything into 13. Or 14. Nope. Hernemi breaks early. Great job from Pontus moving up into 4th. Back in sector 2 there. Just going to briefly jump to Bissell, Poen on win. This is a pretty sick battle too. Alright, last lap. Let's see what we got. We've also got Shogun right behind Lorenz. This is getting spicy. I don't know where to go. There are a lot of battles now. Alright. It looks like Shogun did get ahead of Lorenz, stealing at the last gasp here. There's so many good battles. I don't know if Pete's going to get up to Lorenz by the time... Sorry, Pete's going to get up to Kjellgren by the time he gets around Lorenz. Which I assume is going to happen. Lexus has the advantage here in some places. Pika, I think, is... I don't really think he'll move up. I could be wrong. I've been wrong before. These guys are all pretty tight, too. There's so much going on. It all comes down to the last lap. We'll watch this top group for a bit. Yeah, Pete got around him. Looks like it's going to be Shogren, then Ritzelainen and Lorenz across the line. 1, 2, 3. Lorenz killing it, having a wonderful drive. Started first, ending third as an AM driver. Miles ahead of the next AM Flash driver. Pete is coming up here. He's very much kept in touch. Pontus started to pull away a little bit. Coming down to 13 here. Just a few corners to go. They're both sliding. They both want it. Pika's gonna have to make a crazy lunge if he wants anything. Looks like Poe is also fighting with Unwin back there. This is so tight. Alright, that's third. That's first, second, third. And it looks like Chris isn't quite going to get it across the line. Keep going down the timing sheets here. To these guys, this is the battle for the final podium spot in AM. Bissell looks like he's got it at the moment. Just two corners to go. 15 and 16. Mid-speed left-handers. And behind them, Poe and Unwin. Oh, just kidding, they're on the back straight. I misread completely where they were on the track. Alright, this is spicier than I thought. I do think Bissell's got it at this point, but Poe and Unwin, it's all up for grabs. Oh no! Bissell's sliding through 14. It's a lot closer now. Doesn't look like anything's going to get done in the last turn. Bissell holds on to take the final podium spot in the AM class. Behind him, Steve Poe and Tion Nguyen come across the line. Go down to Slater, if I can get there. This is pretty close, too. We're on the back straight here. This is the last battle on the track. BMW doing everything. He's probably got damage or he's low on fuel or something, because that was a very defensive line. One turn to go. Who's it going to be? Looks like Walker's going to hold on from Slater. 17th and 18th. What a race! I feel like there were a lot of DNFs. That was a good race. That was very solid. Congratulations to Jogren, Rutzlainen, and Lorenz for top three. Good stuff, everyone. This has been the second round of DRL. EU season. Sprint race. Reverse grid. Take care, everyone. Peace out. And have a wonderful weekend. Happy Independence Day to the Americans. Where's my mouse? Can't free my mouse from the game. There we go.